Now, out of these four equations, we will have to derive the transmission and the reflection coefficients. So, I will, as this is just very simple mathematics, means dealing with the equations, just eliminating some constants and eliminating one from the other and then putting in the next equation, we will get this. But let me write the very big steps here. If I multiply equation 1 by sine LA and equation 3 by multiply by cos LA, but is 1 L is more, so I divide by L as well. When I do this and I add them, these two, 1 and 3, when I add them up, so I will get that C is equal to F E I K A sine of LA plus IK over L and cos LA. Similarly, if I do the reverse here, that I multiply 1 by cos LA and 3 by sine LA by L, then, and I do instead of addition the subtraction, then I will get D in terms of F. So it will be, if I multiply 1 by cos LA and equation 3 by sine LA over L, and I do subtract them, then I will get that D is equal to F I K A and cos LA minus I K over L and sine LA. So I got C in terms of F and D in terms of F, and now I put these two in equation 2, and equation 2 will be, then when I put in equation 2, so in equation 2 I am having A and B there and C and D there, so I will have to put in terms of C this value, and for D I will put this value in equation 2, and I do a two-step simplification. I will get that F, that A E I K X plus, this will be minus K A plus B E I K A is equal to cos 2 LA cos 2 L A and minus I K over L sine 2 LA and multiplied with F I K A. Similarly, equation 4, if I do put the value of C and D in equation 4, I will get A E minus I K A minus B E I K A is equal to cost willing, cost willing minus I L over K sine willing, and F E I K A. So I will get these two equations, and now I can, let's say this is equation 5 and this is equation 6, and now I know if I add them up, then these two will cancel, and here A will be, and here F will survive. So I can get F in terms of A from here. Similarly, in the next step, if I subtract them, then A will cancel and B will survive here, F will survive here. So I will get F in terms, I will get B and F in terms of B as well, but that is not my interest. My interest is to get the transmission. So for the transmission, I will have to use the F and A here. So if I add 5 and 6, then we will get, and after simplification, we will get the inverse of transmission, or I can write this in terms of F, and this is equal to E minus 2IKA and capital A whole divided by cos 2LA minus I over 2KL sine 2LA plus into K square plus L square. So this will give F in terms of A, and I can now write that transmission, which is F square over A squared. So this transmission, if I reciprocate, and this is T minus 1, means A square over F square, it will be after some simplification, and by putting the value of L and the value of K here, we will get the transmission inverse is 1 plus V naught square divided by 4E plus V naught sine squared and 2A over H bar 2M E plus V naught square root, and this is the domain of sine square. So we will get the transmission inverse in this form, and now I can see that when this portion is zero, when this all is zero, the transmission inverse will be 1, so it will imply that T is equal to 1. So whatever wave that has entered our well has gone transmitted. It is no more experiencing the potential there. And that we call that the potential has become transparent for it. There is no bound state, or means the entering wave is equal to the outgoing wave. The transmission is 1, So let me, means the well has become transparent. So you see how this thing is possible. I know that V naught is non-zero and I know that E is non-zero. So this coefficient of sine square is non-zero. This can only be possible, means 100% transmission is only possible if we will have, this term equal to zero. This is non-zero, so sine square of this is equal to zero, and this is only possible if the domain of sine, that is when sine square x is equal to zero, I can write this as sine x whole squared is equal to zero, and this is zero. This is zero only if x will be equal to zero, for x equal to zero, and when this is equal to n pi. So n is equal to the value, the integral value, means this is 0 for pi, for 2 pi, 3 pi and so on. So we will have all the possibilities that when x is equal to n pi, then we will have this term equal to 0. So when the sine square domain here, when this is equal to n pi, this implies that 2a over h bar 2m e plus v naught is equal to n pi, where n is an integer 0, 1, 2 and so on. So it is an integer. Now, think of this thing. Can x be 0? Means this is x, for example. So can this be 0? No. Because all these values can be non-zero. So I can write that this n is 1, 2, an integer. And we will have to exclude this one, but to keep this equal to n pi, 1, 2, 3, all integral values here. So when this is the situation, then we will have a perfect transmission. And a perfect transmission will be, I can now simplify by square both sides, then this will be equal, implied that n square pi square, then h bar square, so n square pi square h bar square, and this will be 2 over a squared, but when this is squared, this 2 will also go there, so I can write that en plus v naught is equal to this 2m and then 2a squared. Now if I look at these energies, then n squared pi squared h bar squared 2m times the width of the well were the energies of the infinite square well. So we got exactly the same energies which were for the infinite square well. The infinite square well energies, now this well is having width 2a, while the one we calculated was having the width equal to a. So En plus V naught. Now these are actually the bound energies that when we will have the transmission equal to 1, means when 100% wave will be transparent, when the well or the potential will become transparent for the wave, then we will get the infinite square well energies En plus V naught equal to this. I can plot the sine square here, and if I do plot it, let me plot this way, we will understand it more. And this is, for example, we are having energy here, and on this side, let's say I'm having the transmission, the T. Let's say this is the value 1 for transmission. We will have 100% transmission. So putting values here means putting the values of the sine square here, because this is coefficient, it will add up. But look here, that this transmission inverse is varying a sine square, so it is not like sine. For sine, we have sine wave will go like this, and when it will become sine square, this is for the sine x, and when it is sine square x, then it will become like this, sine squared. So the negative will also become positive. So this wave, let's say this is let's say t equals 1, so this will increase and will touch here, then will come down and will go like this, means oscillations will be there, and finally it will touch this one. So we will have this oscillation is not like this one, like coming down from to the negative, but it is like this one. If I plot, because is the energy is increasing, the variable here we are having E, as the energy is increasing, the well will become more and more transparent, and the sine oscillation will reduce, and these are all actually positive in nature, like this. So this is somehow like this one, that it increases and it goes and touches one after some energy. So we will have the oscillatory behavior, and as the energy will go beyond a certain point, we will have a perfect transmission for this wave. When the energy will be less, then we will have the infinite square well energies, means the well will not be transparent, but some oscillations will be there, it will be feeling that potential. But as the E will be increased, we will get 100% transmission, and the well will become transparent. The well will not be affected by the potential which is over there. And this one, for finding all these constants is actually problem 2.32. So one can solve that problem in order to find out these constants. I have done the major steps, the individual steps and simplification one can do while solving problem 2.32.